River crossings on bikes can be heaps of fun, but fast-flowing deep water requires a bit of thought if you want to avoid drowning your bike. A combination of deep, fast-flowing water and a rocky, unpredictable bottom meant that on this day, about half of the 25 riders that took on this crossing had difficulty. Two bikes were sunk and a further two were drowned. I spoke with New Zealand enduro legend Joe Forsyth as to what was the best way to take on this crossing.
They need to go out about 6 metres till the flow starts and then go right down over to this corner.
But so you're going with the water.
Yeah, what they're doing is the slack water's on the far side and you can actually come out a wee bit before the current gets you. As soon as the current gets you, you've got to go down quick enough for it to stop blowing the back end of the bike upstream. If you gas it, you spin the back end spins and loses traction and the current washes it away more.
This rider needed to enter the river crossing further upstream to go with the flow of water, rather than fighting it. Finally, here's Dave Mack, showing us all how it should be done. He starts way upstream, and then moves downstream when he gets into deep water.
And find their way to my guitar. And we're down into the blues.